My name is Ahmad Farooq, and I belong to Halka Baldia Town, Karachi. For the last whole year, I've been living in Sunderland, and I'm doing MBA from Sunderland University. My papa, Farooq Ahmed Khan Usab, is president of the Halka for the last 12 years. So during the recent times, the conditions in Karachi have not been good for Jamaat, and I went back to Pakistan on 6th of October for my brother's wedding. My brother's name is Saad Farooq Kahlu. So the brother's wedding was planned on 15th of October. I went back. Everyone was happy. It was a joyful event. So we were having fun. So everything went according to the plan. The wedding was on 15th. Then the Walima was on 16th. And on 19th, we went for the Jummah prayers. As we were returning back from it, we were five people in the car. Papa was driving the car. I was sitting at the back. So, bhai, my brother Saad Farooq, he was following us on a motorbike. He was on Papa's duty, as directed by Kaid Saab. So, he was following us on a motorbike. So, we heard a gunshot, and we all went down as my uncle shouted that it's a gunshot. So, as soon as this happened, I saw two men on a motorbike. They just passed a car from the right side, and they came in front and stopped a car and opened fire on us. So my papa got shot 6 or 7 times, and I got shot on my forehead, and my brother's father-in-law, who was sitting in the front, he got shot as well. So bhai was martyred on the spot over there, and as my uncle shouted that Saad is down, papa turned the car, and we put bhai in the car. He was on my lap, so he expired on the spot. So then Papa drove the car around 15 kilometers with those gunshots and the gun with the bullets in him. And we went to the nearest hospital over there. When I was telling, I came to know that bhai has expired. So when I got shot, I was shouting like, Papa, I've lost my sight. Papa, I've lost it. So it was horrible. It was painful. So, but when I saw bhai that he wasn't responding, I was like, Bhai, get up. He wasn't responding. So, no one has been through all this. So, at that time, I was shouting that, Papa, please hurry up, drive the car as fast as possible. Just get to the hospital. So, it was like that. So, I can't really explain how it was. That was the first time he didn't respond ever. Yeah, I would say we all were very happy. He was very excited for the wedding as well. Everyone else for his wedding. So not only him, but whole of my family, I would say. It was the first wedding at home, and we never knew it's going to be the last at home as well. So it was on 15th of October. As I said, we were very happy. The wedding was, everyone was so happy. And on 16th was the Walima, and on that day all the Jamaat gathered for the Walima. That included Amir Saab and Nizamullah, then Khudam al-Ahmadiyya and Nizamullah. Bhai was working as Nazim Amur Talba with Qaid Sabzullah. So Nizamullah was there, then Papa was president, so Amir Saab Nizamullah was there. So all of them congratulated on the wedding. Everyone was happy. And we never knew this can happen this way, although Papa had many threats, and as being a president, because few days before, Orangi Town's president was also assassinated, Naeem Gondal Saab. So we knew something can happen, but we never knew that this can happen this way. And 2 days after this, after his wedding, he can be murdered. The way Huzoor was asking regarding us, Huzoor was being reported every hour or every second hour regarding our health. So we were very satisfied, alhamdulillah. There were khudam all the time over there for the duties. So I know I've lost one brother, but I've got many others standing out there. 2 days after the wedding, no wife can imagine losing a husband, and her father is still in ICU. He's still got the bulletin, and he's still very serious. So you can imagine a girl who just got married 2 days before, lost her husband, and don't know anything of what's going to happen with her father as well. So, of course, it's very distressful as well. Of course, I do love Pakistan. Pakistan is my country, I think, and Jamaat has given so many sacrifices and in terms of lives even for making of Pakistan. And that is what Hazur has been directing us as well, that just pray for Pakistan and the people of Pakistan. Of course, it's my homeland. I'm always going to love it. I think I would say that as Hazur has been telling us and teaching us that the only weapon we have got is of prayers, so we should be the only thing we can do is just pray to Allah Ta'ala that may Allah Ta'ala guide us as well as those people who are doing all this. May Allah Ta'ala put them right on the right track again and guide them. So I would say the prayers are the only thing that a khadim should be doing in all these circumstances. Otherwise, we can't be violent. That's not simply allowed in Jamaat. So the only thing is prayers. That's it.
To keep up to date with the latest videos from the Ahmadiyya Muslim Youth Association, subscribe to the MKUK Videos YouTube channel. Or, for more information about the Ahmadiyya Muslim community, log on to www.alislam.org.